Oh, right, it's already another video. It's only the next day from when I reached Pioneer. Anyway, before I get underway, a little suggestion. If you haven't already checked there, take a look at Barnard's Star. The reason I suggest that is a few days ago I heard from somebody, I can't remember who it was, and he was saying that he had a Viper Mark IV there, which he hadn't bought, it just turned up. And then yesterday I had someone else tell me that they had one. It was Ankerlime, who I'm sure I'm constantly saying his name wrong, but you know what I mean. Well, if you're him, you know, I mean you. And he told me the same thing. He had a Viper Mark IV there. Now, the first time I heard it, I was like, oh, right, okay. And then I just forgot about it. Then when I heard again somebody else had one, I thought, right, I'll take a look. And sure enough, I had one as well. Now, at the time, I had just... I was getting permits, and I wasn't that far away. I was only about 90 light years, so you know, three jumps and I was there. So I quickly went over there just to sell the thing. And then not 5 minutes after I'd sold it, I heard from somebody else, this time Andy Pipkin, or Praetor, as he goes on the YouTube comments, saying that he had found one, he had one there. So it looks like, well, if you qualify for it, I don't know what you particularly had to do or needed to have bought in order to get one, but it looks like a lot of players have a Viper Mark IV waiting for him in Barnard Star. So if you haven't checked there, have a look, see if you've got one there. And at the very least, you can flog it and get another 300 and something thousand credits back. Anyway, for this video, I'm currently in Leighton's half second 134, and my destination is here, Leighton's 4/10 65. I'm very close to it, only 3.92 light years. Now, I haven't been here before, but some of you may recognise that system and may know why I'm going there. I'll be honest, it was only until like about, what, 4 or 5 days ago that I found out about this. Commander Ripperjack, who seems to have been bored into a coma with Elite Dangerous over the last couple of days, he gave me a link to a video which was frankly unbelievable. It's a very rare thing for me to have actually watched this video, because I don't watch too many Elite Dangerous videos anyway, and if I do watch one and see that they've done the fart arsing about with changing the colour scheme, I switch off straight away, because it looks like shit. You have to sort of pretty much jimmy-rig the thing to get it to work, and it looks like it. So, yeah, okay, they've changed the colour scheme, but they've made the game look fucking awful. So I can't stand it, and I won't watch videos made by people who have done that. But this one I persevered, and I'm glad I did. So, let's get on the way. And we'll see, I'm back in the Asp. I was in the Imperial Cutler for a bit. I even took it to a conflict zone with a Commander Life School Amiga. That was back in the Het. Once I finish here, I'm going to head back to the Het, because I'm sick to death with the Asp. I want to get back in the Cutler. But this has a good jump range, obviously, so it meant that getting out here would be easy.
Engines engaged. Landing gear retracted.
Now, I didn't notice something when I was handing in my data yesterday, but when I first landed and was checking my integrity, I had, it was over 30,000 in order to repair it. But the first thing I did was sort out the paint job, which was only about 50-something credits. It took the payment for that, 50-odd, but it also fixed the integrity for nothing. So I saved myself 30,000 credits there. So there you go, another shining example of Frontier Development's quality. But if you want a real example of Frontier Development's quality, unless they have fixed it, which I highly doubt, watch on. Before anybody points it out, yes, I know I spelt Vipoxark wrong. I didn't have room for the second K. Alright, so we have what looks like a white dwarf. That's not the thing I'm interested in. Alright, let's go to the system map. Now the planet I am interested in is this one. Lightning the 41065-2. Specifically, I'm interested in this moon. Lightning the 41065-2A. So what I'm going to do, I'll scan this system because it doesn't look like it's going to take a huge amount of time. I'm only going to do the gas giants. And then we'll come back once that is done. So back when the scanning is finished. Okay, I'm not 100% sure if the first video worked. So just to recap, we are in the Lightning's 41065 system. Now I've scanned all of the planets. I haven't bothered with any of the moons. Because I don't usually bother. But this particular one I am bothering with. Now it's a worthless icy body. We can land on it. Now as we get closer, you may notice something. It's very, very close to the ring system of this planet. In fact, it's more than very close to it. Now there's nothing unusual about moons of gas giants being within the ring systems. But there is something rare, shall we say, about a ring system going right the way through a planet. And as you can see, that's what's happening here. Another shining example of fantastic Frontier Development's quality. So let's take a closer look then, shall we? Does being, you know, this close to the ring system mean that it's going to give us some problems? Because if this goes tits up, then there's a chance my ship could end up being destroyed. In which case I'll finally have a third death. Right, well, let's have a look. And so the ring system is just going straight through the planet. Right through it. Right, now we're dropping from the orbital cruise, now we're entering the glide. Getting closer and closer to it. Still nothing as far as, you know, is it gonna, you know, make us crash or anything. Still getting there, still getting closer. What staggeringly great quality, you know, from good old Frontier developments. So, yeah, okay, well, I'll tell you what, let's land here. Gravity is fine at 0.15, don't need to worry about that. If you were approaching this planet, you would have, or you would believe, there is something rather more urgent to worry about than the gravity of this particular moon. Oops, looks like I'm coming down a bit hard. Oh, unsuitable terrain, but now it's telling me it is okay. There we go, alignment okay. Well, let's see if it fucking let me land there. Okay. Let's have a look. Now, because you come out of here facing the rear. And you'd be thinking, well, the place looks a bit boring. But, yeah, it's a planet, all right. And then, what the fuck is that? So the ring system of the planet is just going right through us. Well, let's try a test then, let's see. Will we crash into it if we actually approach the thing? I can't even see whereabouts it is. I think we're still quite some way off. I mean, didn't anyone think to, you know, test for anything like this? Or did they just think, oh, this would be a good idea? You know, and because of the haphazard, unbelievably shoddy, we can't be bothered job that Frontier Developments always do, there was a certain inevitability that something like this would happen. But, I mean, even so. might be taking a bit of a tumble now. Okay, so my ship has now left. Actually, I'm getting a signal. Okay, let's see what's here. Past it. Alright, what we got? Iron, phosphorus, phosphorus, and iron. So, a huge sack of fuck all. Just for a change. Now, there was another signal just around here. That's handy, it's going to take us towards the ring again, so we'll investigate this one. Close to it. I think that's it there, yep. Phosphorus germanium. Can't remember how much germanium I've got. It doesn't really matter, I've got a full bloody hole anyway. I've got 22 of them. Okay, so I certainly don't need any more. Alright. Let's keep going. Oh, we've got another signal. So I wonder how many of these meteorites are actually, you know, could they be actually parts of the entire fucking ring system that's going right through this fucking moon like a circular saw? Close. Ah, okay, I see it. Alright, iron, nickel, carbon, phosphorus, fuck all. There's another one, another signal over here. What I'll do, I'll check out this signal, but it looks like it's taking too long to actually drive to there, so once I've checked this one out, we'll recall the ship and see if, well, we'll obviously get there quicker taking the ship there. Bollocks, this one's going to take us away from it. That's it there, yep. Right, what have we got here? Nickel, phosphorus, sulfur, iron. That's another steaming sack of fuckle. Okay, let's recall the ship then, see where it lands. it is fucking laughable. Quality control, eh? Who needs it? Or more the case, who needs it more than Frontier Developments do? Alright, so where's the ship gone? Well, it looks like it's up ahead. Oh yeah, there it is. So it almost looks like it's flying through the ring system. I think it was, because it's now only now appearing in the on the scanner. So it must have flown through the ring system. Well, it flew through it, no problem. It's not taken any damage to the shield or the hull, so... get on board. Crater, that's the word I was looking for. Right. I'm trying to see from this view whereabouts it's appearing. It's definitely between me and the horizon. It's a long way before the horizon. But, yeah, I'm not even mass locked by it. If I wasn't, you know, in... or this close to the surface of a planet, and I was this close to a fucking planet's ring system, I would certainly be mass locked by it. Alright, we're now very close. Now it's saying mass lock. And now it looks like we're going right through it now. Yep, so we're now travelling right through it. Okay, I'll tell you what, as we seem to be actually within it, let's come down.
Landing gear deployed.
Like we're landing right in on the edge of an enormous crater. I'd be amazed if we can land here. A rock that's just floating in midair. Several rocks floating in midair. Yeah, this terrain is completely unsuitable. Let's get out of the crater. Whoa, hang on. It's saying we could land here, even though we'd probably have to be at some ridiculous angle. Alignment okay. So we've got rocks floating in midair. Now I've seen that before. A screenshot that again Commander Ipperjack showed me of how it was looking. Awesome. There we go. Right, so I've managed to land in this ridiculous position. Whoa, what was that? Fuck knows what that was. Okay, let's see if we can go out in the old So we are now driving around in the surface rover inside the ring system that's going through this planet like a circular saw blade. It's just fucking, what is this all about? Let's get an external shot of this. Right, let's zoom out a bit. Go up. I mean, for fuck's sake. I mean, I could be ranting about it, but I really am just lost for words. Just the complete bollocks of the whole thing. So there we are. We are on LFT 65-2A. We have landed right in the middle of the ring system of the planet that this moon is orbiting. A ring system that is cutting through the planet like a circular saw blade. And not only can I land there, I can go and drive around in my SRV. So, you know, well there you are. The bollocks planet. So if you fancy seeing something that is just utterly laughable, there's even a fucking point of interest not too far from here. This way, I think. I'm going too fast to be able to, I think I'm now also too high. It's So we've got rocks and that from, looks like from the fucking, I can't see the point of interest, so let's just say it's buggered off. Who cares? Alright, we're not mass locked anymore, charging. Let's bugger off. Whoops. Oh, fuck it. Ship's overheating. Where's the escape? Oh, okay, so the escape trajectory is... Yeah, the escape trajectory is going to be completely in line with the... in fact, it's going to put me in heading towards the ring system.
Frameshift drive charging. Engage.
Oh, there you go. So that is LFT-65-2A. If you want to see a moon that is just utter bollocks, this is the place to go. Alright, now, where did I came from there? Let's just fuck off out of here. Oh well, looks like I can't. I've got to get to the other side of the planet first. Whoops. Ah, so now it's dropped me out because I'm too close to the ring system. So when I was, you know, actually parked in the middle of it, no, that wasn't too close. I was able to keep going. But now I'm out here. No, that's... I can't do that. Fucking, what is this?
4, 3, 2, 1, engage.
And even when my ship left and I recalled it, it looked like the ship flew right through the ring system. Oh. Anyway, so that is that system done. That is taking the piss, so this is Commander Lukosa saying go away.